Hello everyone, welcome to Yadhu Study Hub. My name is Sushma and today we'll be understanding the term jurisprudence. Basically, the subject is very important for regular LLB exams and other competitive exams like CLAT, NET and judiciary exams. So in today's class, we'll be understanding the evolution, objective, importance and meaning of the term jurisprudence. The main object of the jurisprudence is to give theoretical foundation for law. So what is law? The term law has been defined by various scholars and jurists from time to time, but there is no definite definition for the term law. In general, law means a set of rules and regulation where a person has to obey, and if he fails to do so, then he'll be liable to the punishment. The punishment may vary from fine to imprisonment. See, law is a social science. It grows and develops with the society. With the society touching new levels of development, law is required to cover new fields and to move in new direction. To keep pace with the society, the function and the scope of law remains always changing. So it is very difficult for a definition of law given at a particular time to remain valid for all times to come. A definition which is most satisfactory today might prove narrow and incomplete tomorrow. So that is why we don't have universal definition for the term law. But I'll be explaining this topic in my upcoming class. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the notification button so that whenever I post a new video, you'll be updated. Now coming back to the subject, the evolution of jurisprudence. Only during the Roman period, the beginning of legal science started. The term jurisprudence is of Roman origin, signifying knowledge of law. The Romans were the first to study the legal science as a distinct branch of learning. Now let us understand the word jurisprudence. So what is jurisprudence? The word jurisprudence has been derived from Latin word jurisprudentia, which means knowledge of law. Juris means law and prudentia means skill or knowledge. So what it attempts to explain is, it attempts to explain the nature of law and its interaction with the life of the community. In the life of the community, the relationship of man with the properties with the other man are involved. So every system of law has got certain basic concepts like property, ownership rights, punishments, liability. So jurisprudence tries to explore and explain such basic concepts of law. So it is very important to remember that it is a conceptual, jurisprudence is a conceptual analysis of theory of law correlated to socio-political goal of a society, which provide explanation, justification and meaning to the totality of legal system. So jurisprudence is the name given to a certain type of investigation into law, an investigation of an abstract, general and theoretical nature which seeks to lay the bare the essential principles of law and legal system. So why it is very important to study jurisprudence? By study of jurisprudence, a person knows the basis of law, he gains knowledge of the basic ideas and the fundamental principles of law. The study of jurisprudence also helps lawyer to solve new and difficult legal problems. For example, the knowledge of rules constituting possession would help a lawyer to find out who is the actual possessor of a property. So it not only helps a lawyer, but it also helps the court in interpreting the true meaning of legislation and customs. So the study of jurisprudence also helps to suggest changes for the betterment of existing laws. So now let us understand the meaning. So jurisprudence is the study of fundamental legal principle. That study may be philosophical, scientific, historical. Jurisprudence is the study of positive law. What is positive law? Positive law means the actual existing law as distinguished from the ideal or what the law should be. So this question might be asked for MCQ questions like jurisprudence is a study of dash. It is a study of positive law, which means Jurisprudence is the study of fundamental legal principles, and it is concerned with the normative and not merely the positive. It is concerned not merely with actual but also with the ideal. So in today's class, we understood that jurisprudence introduces reasoning to the study of law, and it sets the goal of law for an ideal order in which justice, social, economic and political is assured to all people in the state. The definition of the jurisprudence I'll be explaining in my next class. So if you liked my video, like and subscribe to my channel, and if you have any questions, leave it in a comment box. See you in my next class. Thank you.